Hello friends, in our last lecture I have discussed about the planning of experiments, how the number of experiments be varied depending upon number of factors and their levels. So how can we choose the orthogonal array? Either we have to choose L27 or we have to choose L9, L18, mixed array or some other type of array depending upon their factors and respective levels. So today I will discuss about the Taguchi method. So for better understanding, I have select one research paper. I will produce the results of that research paper on this using this Minitab software. So for better understanding, so that anybody who will watch this video can easily implement this software in their research work. So basically, Taguchi method is for single response optimization. Initially we plan our experiment depending upon number of factors and number of levels, and after that, depending upon the response, we will analyze the things. So starting from that thing, initially this is the research paper. I have selected this research paper, so anybody, I think it is an open access research paper, so here you can easily see there are some process parameters, and the Taguchi L16 orthogonal array is selected for this ultimate tensile strength and elongation, and there are 4 factors and each level is 4 factors and 4 levels each. So initially I have to start this Minitab. So anybody who want to implement this Taguchi method can initially select any paper so that he can check whether he is able to implement or he still needs some clarification in this regard. After the implementation, you want to know some terms. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of R square, your adjusted R square? And what is the meaning of, you can say that standard deviation and all other terms. So now it's time to start. So I will make this like this. So okay, fine. Okay, fine. So also there are 4 tool: rotation speed, welding speed, tool pin profile. And here you can see pin profile is cylindrical, threaded, cylindrical, square and trapezoidal. However, in the paper it is written as 1 2 3 4. So 1 for cylindrical, 2 for this, 3 for square, 4 for trapezoidal, because the meaning is that the Taguchi method, in Taguchi method we have to take some quantitative value. Okay, so we have to convert those value either 1 or 2 or some other form. So it is a 4 level and number of factors are also 4. Here is 4 level. So last time when we discussed about this thing, so it comes that depending upon 3 level, 3 factor, and there are some interaction, then we have two option, not the interaction, but for linear purpose we have only L9, but when we consider some interaction, then there is L27. So for some higher things like mixed array, we have L18. Similarly, for 4 factors, 4 level, we have this available design is, we can say that 16. So 16. Now factors, I have to write factors, tool rotation speed. So I think it is better, tool rotation speed. Okay, and second is welding speed. Third one is it is tool pin profile, then tool shoulder diameter. Okay, tool pin profile, and I simply write shoulder diameter. This is shoulder dia. Okay, so what is the values of this? 1200 1950. Okay, 1200 1950, 3080, I think last one is 4600. Yes, last one is 4600. The welding speed, in welding speed it is 20, 25, 30, 35 mm per minute. 20, 25, 30, 35 mm per minute. Tool pin profile, as you know that these are 1, 2, 3, 4. And last one is tool shoulder diameter are 14, 16, 18 and 20. So 14, 18, 16 and 20. So it's okay. And option, it's okay. So okay. So this is our, we can say the design of experiment. Okay, so these are the values. Ultimate tensile strength, it is 230, 20, 240, 385. So therefore for fast thing, I think not this one. Okay, tables. For the faster thing, otherwise I have to type everything. So therefore for to cover very fast, or we can say that to save time, I just copied all the tables, right? These tables here. So these are the ultimate tensile strength. Okay, so these values are same as given in paper. So I have to write here. Okay, so it is UTS. If you want to write, you can also write here the units, which are mega pascal of this. Now I think many of time when you watch different type of research paper in this area, you find that maximum of the people use a single value of the response. However, in case of Taguchi, when you when you study every paper, most of the person use this single type of thing. But in Taguchi we have to take at least three values due to calculation of signal to noise ratio. It is mandatory to take three readings or range basically. So most of the person, what they can do, they take three values, they record those three values or four values or five values, but they use during the analysis purpose or during the manuscript, in the manuscript they can use mean value of that. But for reproducibility, we can say that or for statistical accuracy, they use three values which they already define in the manuscript, that they have selected 3, 2, 4 values like this, and the mean value is used in this analysis. So I think this will be the mean value. So our main aim is to understand the thing first, that how can we implement, how can we use this software, and after that how can we implement the things and what is the significance of that. But when you do the research, then at that time at least you have to take three values, at least three, or maybe if it is four larger run, then it is better. So we have to run. Now you watch this thing, the DOE, this is the Taguchi, then you have to analyze the result. Then okay, fine, select your this thing and this one, then analysis. It is analysis is you have to calculate signal to noise ratio, also you have to calculate the mean for fit linear model. Okay, fine. And terms, you have in the initial condition you have to take all four terms or all the terms initial for the first analysis. Okay, analysis graph. And it should be regular, or here you can use individual plot or you can use 4-in-1. If you choose this one, then all the four plots you have to get in separately, but in this there is a plot, and in the same plot you can find out four subsets. Okay, fine. Option, as it is an important thing, because UTS, we can say that ultimate tensile strength, higher will be the ultimate tensile strength, then we can say that better will be our weld joint. So here, depending upon the selection of the parameter, so here we have to choose larger is better. So okay, and storage, in storage for the analysis purpose we have to choose these two, or you also choose three, then here also choose three. These are for the following terms. For fits and residuals we have to choose this one, okay, fits and residual this, okay, then okay. So you can find out, we get these four plot initially. This is starting from this main plot, main effect plot for mean. This is main effect plot for SN ratio, okay, and this is residual plot for SN ratio, this is residual plot for mean, and this is our, we can say that the session or worksheets, our worksheet. What will be, what data will we will get after this analysis? What will be the value of ANOVA, analysis of variance for S signal to noise ratio or SN ratio, or what will be the value of your ANOVA for mean, their response table, and R square, adjusted R square. All these values you can get, like model summary says that it is a standard deviation basically for this one, SN ratio. Standard deviation is this one, R square and adjusted R square, okay. And from this, basically I will tell you the terms. This is degree of freedom, this is sum of square, this is adjusted sum of square, this is adjusted mean square, this is the tabulated F value, F ratio, or this is our P value. So the term to be significant in the analysis, on we can say that 95% significance, our P value should be less than 0.05. So here only one term we can say, that tool pin profile, that is a non-significant term, because this value is greater than 0.05 in the which is suggested by ANOVA for SN ratios, okay. SN ratio is signal to noise ratio. Here your model summary, this is for mean, mean value, your standard deviation is this R square, adjusted R square. And then as per this analysis, tool pin profile is shows that this term is non-significant for the analysis of your ultimate tensile strength. So the value as per the SN ratio, as per the, we can say that mean, your third term tool pin profile is insignificant, okay. And larger is we can say that response table for signal to noise ratio, this is the response table for SN ratio, this is the response table for mean. But as we know that our one term is non-significant, so in that case, if any value, if it is, suppose in our case it is 2, but in some other case it may be 2, in our case it is 1, but maybe in some other case it may be 2 or 3. How many terms shows p value greater than 0.05, we have to remove those term, or we can say that we have to pull those term from our analysis. So that's why we have to again do our analysis again. This is Taguchi, again we have to analyze our Taguchi design, and then all terms remain same except this term, okay. So in this, because this is insignificant term, so we have to pull it. So from this selected term we have to pull back, pulled out, and now we have to analyze these terms only, okay. So it is okay, and it is also okay. So now first I have to move these four graphs here. From the graph it is clear that your tool pin profile is removed from the analysis. However, before going to these graph, I want to tell you something regarding these one, okay. The value you can see, this is the value when you consider tool pin profile, but after pulling it is this one. So you can watch the graph remains same in both cases except here it is tool pin profile, and in this plot there will be no tool pin profile. Okay, same you can also observe for SN ratio, tool pin profile is here, and in that case there will be no tool pin profile. But the important thing is that here you can watch, it is normal probability plot, and all the four residual are like this. This is histogram is also is some straight form before pooling, but when we pulled out our insignificant term from the analysis, then it seems like this. Okay, like this. Now you have to watch this figure. In that histogram is some straight, we can say that bars, but in this case it is starting from like this, so and more or less like this parabola type. Okay, now what is the significance of these four graphs? The significance is simple. These are the residual plots. These residual plots in our previous analysis, these are some like this, some straight line. Okay, like this. But in this, all the residual are false on this straight line or distributed on this straight line, which is mandatory. These are basically four tests for good ANOVA, which are basically required when, which is goodness, or we can say that good model, that all the residual should be on this straight line. When you read some research paper, then that research paper also defines the same thing, that this is our normality test, and in the normality test your residual should be on false on this straight line. Then second graph, it is residual and versus fitted value. So in this test we can say that the test, the ANOVA, the model should be good when these residuals should be far from this center line, and also these are randomly distributed, they do not make any type of cluster. Okay, so when it is like this, or we can say randomly distributed, then we can say that our fitted versus residual test is good. Okay, now histogram, it should not be straight histogram. Histogram should be like parabola or some other figure, but not the straight one, like we can say that in our previous case it is okay, if residual, like if it is like, it is straight case. So we have to avoid this thing. If you got some straight curve, then definitely you have to make some mistake in your reading, so we have to make another reading. Okay, so our histogram test says that it should form some parabola for some better results. And here we can say that the observation, or we can say that time variance study is good only when it do not show any rectic changes. Suppose this line initially go from upward, and once upward then finally goes downward like this. So these rectic changes, we have to avoid these changes. If these type of changes are observed, then we can say that time variance study is not good. So in that case we had made some mistake during our analysis, or we have to made some mistake during our experimentation. So you have to go again for experiments. Okay, so these are the things, and these are the values. Now this is the standard deviation value. Standard deviation value basically that value which is suppose we have one insignificant term in this analysis, or the number of insignificant terms, or we can say number of noise factors, the variability in the result due to noise factors is this one. The amount of variability in the result is this one for SN, or we can say that SN ratio varies in this much of amount due to noise factors. Similarly, for the noise factors, the value of standard deviation varies up to this factor. So this is the SN ratio 000. I think it is better to show you paper results. So it is 00004. so like this. So you have to check these are the response tables. Old ANOVA for okay. I think it is 000004. I think 160.92.74.22. So you can check this and this one are same. Okay, so we can produce the result. These are I have to show you. I only showed you about the ultimate tensile strength, not for the percentage elongation. So because the main aim is to show you how can we reproduce our result, not to exactly to replicate the paper, but to show you how to operate this software for this Taguchi method. Okay, so the next thing, okay, so next thing is this one, response table for UTS. Here it is A, B and D, or basically it's a C has been pulled out. So this is our ultimate 241, 236, this is 123, this is 123, 19.699, the table is same. So these two table we have to use here. So now you can find out the ANOVA and all other thing except this R square and adjusted R square. R square is the coefficient of determination. Or we can say that how much the outcomes can be predicted, how much percentage, or we can say the 99.2% outcomes can be predicted by using this analysis or this model. So due to significant and insignificant terms, however, if we consider only the significant terms, then the variability can be explained. 98.01% variability can be explained only due to the significant terms. Therefore, you can say we can say that R square adjusted is either equal or less than R square. Adjusted R square is always less than or equal to, not greater than. It never be greater than R square. So this value is always less than or equal to our R square value. So these are the terms we can use. And degree of freedom, last time I told you how much degree of freedom. If number of levels are 4, then degree of freedom is 3. So if it is L16, the degree of freedom is 16 minus 1, that is 15. Then regarding this, these are the values which are given by, we can say that the software. Then when software is not developed, then how can we calculate these values? So better, because I'm not I do not want to increase or increase the length of this video. So therefore I can say that it is only the part one in which we have to use the software. But if, because most of the time in masters or PhD viva, external examiner asks about if it is software is not there, then how can you calculate standard deviation? What will be the formula for this? What is the formula for mean square? What will be the fair formula for F values? How can we calculate the percentage contribution? So we can also use Excel for this, all these analysis. Okay, so these are the simple terms. So in our next video, I will tell you how can we calculate this manually. Okay, but before concluding all these things, so I also show you one most important thing. Suppose you have to predict your result. Okay, so if you want to predict your result, then in this, the same case Taguchi, then it is predict Taguchi result. Okay, now you have to check this table. Table is because we have to take the response is larger the better type. So I have to select this. Now from this it is select level from a list, so I have to select levels from a list. So these are tool rotation speed, how much, what is the maximum out of these four? I think it is 241, so it is 1. Welding speed is 228, 234, 236, so it is the to fourth level. So this one welding speed, so it is 230, 29, 32, 223. So it is 232, so it means it is at third level. Okay, so you can also check the response table is basically the graph of so this is the SN ratio of the our predicted result, and this is our mean value at the optimized setting. Okay, and what will be the setting we can also calculate from the response table, or we can also watch this graph. In this graph it is the first level, it is up to fourth level, and it is at third level. So when you take your cursor here, then it will also show you the value. Okay, we can also calculate this manually. So using this we can also predict our SN ratio and our mean value, or we can say that the single response optimization. The next step, we can say that the mathematically at 95% confidence interval, there are some terms we have to use those terms for the calculation, which are basically shown, I think, in this paper it is already shown. Okay, yes, this is the analysis. We have to take this analysis like this, and then yes, this one. Okay, so this analysis, in the next lecture I will show you how to calculate the things. I will start from here only, using the same paper, using the same result, so that do not break your flow. Okay, so thank you.